Sorry for the late start, ladies and gentlemen, but the game that I intended to bring you today, apparently I left the controller off the charger, and it's dead. So, instead, we're going to play The Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild for Nintendo Switch. We'll be starting a new game. This will be 100% playthrough attempted. That does mean I'm going to try to get all those stupid little seeds. Wish me luck. It's a lot of little seeds. I mean, it's like, what, 900 of them? That's a lot, guys. That's a lot. Alright, I wanted to start from the absolute beginning. Shiny.
Link.
I mean, it is glowy, so.
That is a Sheikah slate. Take it. It will help guide you after your long slumber.
So this is like, iPhone? What is this, iPhone 12? No. No, this is only a 10. Oh, this is the old model. Aw, man. Well, I guess it'll work. Okay. So if you've never played this game, and at this point, like, who hasn't played this game? Seriously. We got our mini-map down there in the corner. We got our temp gauge. It lets us know if we're too hot or too cold. The little wavy graph thing underneath that tells us how much noise we're making, which, you know, is important. Apparently picking things up is a thing we can do. And then you throw them with a trigger button, which is gonna take me a little getting used to, because pretty much every Zelda game up till now that I've played, I mean, I have played this before, but it's been a little while. Most recently I've been playing Ocarina of Time and Link's Awakening. Those, the throw button is the same button you use to pick up most stuff, if you're able to throw it. Alright, what's in here? Pants. We have pants. That seems like a good idea. Let's put on some pants. We're now wearing pants. Alright, we are on a roll. Shoes? Shirt. It looks like we're already wearing shoes anyway. Okay. We are dressed and ready to go. I think. It's another glowy thing. Let's go check this out. What are you glowing about?
Hold the Sheikah Slate up to the pedestal. That will show you the way.
Okay. So we touch our phone to the thingy. Ah, it's like Google Pay, only for opening doors. Makes sense. Dude. I felt the same way coming out of quarantine.
Our light that must shine upon Hyrule once again. Now go.
Sure. We have a jump button. We can sprint. We can climb. We'll be doing a lot of climbing in this game. A lot of climbing. Dramatic reveal. Of all the Legend of Zelda games, this one is the largest, but also the most visually stunning, in my opinion. Now, don't get me wrong, Twilight Princess was pretty good. I mean, graphics-wise, it was aight, but, Skyward Sword, this, though. I mean, it feels like you're almost playing an anime. And it's Legend of Zelda. Alright, let's pick up some sticks. I don't know how much combat we're gonna run into right away. It's been a long time. And I do mean a long time since I started a new game in Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. All I remember from the start of this is you gotta talk to this old man a whole bunch of times. do some stuff, and then you'll get off of the Great Plateau. And if we can, we want to pick up literally everything, just all of the stuff, 100% of the time. If it can be looted, loot it.
Link, head for the point marked on the map in your Sheikah slate.
Is she going to be a pain in my butt as much as Navi was in Ocarina of Time? Because I'll just put her on ignore. It's a giant rock. We'll probably have some fun with giant rocks later in this game. For now, though, they want us to follow the thing. I don't know why. They think we gotta follow the thing. We has an apple. Come on, that was perfect. You telling me you couldn't grab that on your dash past it? Come on, now. What kind of adventurer are you, Link? Not a very good one. We're having trouble getting this apple. There we go. Ha! We got it. Well, hello, old man. Baked apple. The entire kingdom of Hyrule. Born right here. If that looks familiar, it should. Looks like the Temple of Time. And now we have firewood. Alright, guys. Fun fact, it has been confirmed by the developers of this game that Korok seeds are poo. This little, leaf-faced twig monster is giving me a poo intended for his friend. Who apparently is some kind of poop collector. And there are 900 poops. 899 to go. But the hole, it has a distinctive smell. Don't be shy about poking your nose into suspicious places. Poo jokes. Y'all have poo jokes. We don't need all these sticks. A rusty broadsword, though? Yeah, we can make use of it. Hyrule bass. Okay, I better get out of the water before I drown. That stamina meter is no joke. No joke at all. They take that stuff quite seriously around here. Alright, now. I do have access to all of the DLCs. Want to make sure that we're finding all of the things that that we can. So when we get to Woodland Stable, let's remember to look for that that book. You'll have a clue to the location of the Korok mask. My previous playthrough of this, which I did not stream, just, you know, my own time, I never completed the Trial of the Sword. I, tried it a few times. I did, but I never got it done. So that's a thing I'm going to want to try to complete this time around. Obviously not this session. We've just started. We've got a long way to go. Long way to go. Somewhere on this plateau, though, there are three treasure chests that are distinctly placed here because we have the expansion pass. He gonna want to fight. So let's give him one. I was supposed to pick those up, wasn't I? One thing I learned my last time playing this is every time you come across one of these bad boys, look for stuff. Look for ancient gear to be found underneath it. I don't mean ancient gear like the armor set. I mean ancient gear like the gears, the actual gears, the screws, the bits and bobs of ancient guardians that you can steal to upgrade that stuff. So much for our rusty broadsword. Didn't last very long. How many tree branches we got? Okay, well, let's chuck this one. That's not gonna help anyone. We'll take that. I have no idea if we can kill that boar right now. I'm not terribly coordinated. You know, we're getting into a lot of combat out here. We should probably... Oh, Hyrule Herb, look at that. Okay. Come down a little far, I think. I think I wanted to explore that up there first. We explored this one down here, I think. Yeah. But we didn't check out the ruins up here. Man, I am wrecking these branches. That's okay, though. What's in the treasure chest? Better pants. That's good, too, because pants we had were not providing much cover. What's up this way? Okay, we got one little, one little baddie over there to fight. Fine and dandy to have arrows, but without a way to shoot them, kind of just, what are we going to do, poke them in the eye with it? It just seems silly. I love how they did a really good job of making it feel like this is a really old battlefield. You know? Like everything that happened here really came to an end about that time. Well, hello, sir. When these guys start coming back to life, they're terrifying for about a minute. And I say that because, once you get properly equipped, they are a walk in the park to beat. They really are. More arrows. Hey, we got a bow. We want to preserve those arrows, though, for as long as we can. At least to start with here. Once we get off the plateau, they're not so scarce because, there will be towns we can visit. Shops where we can buy stuff. Although at the start of all this, it does feel extremely desolate, like there's no population, it's all wasteland. Alright, so it's a good thing we ran back up there, because we would have passed up on that traveler's bow. The better pants. There's a ladder here. Soldier's bow. I don't know if we get anything for climbing way up here, or if there's another seed. Oh, hey. Something shiny. There is a seed. Just take a look around. Got some trees to the south. Some more ruins to the east. Looks like a bridge over there. Looks like the way to the castle. Although I'm pretty certain this plateau is not going to let us get terribly far. Like, if we were to go that way, that looks fairly chilly. We would end up freezing our butt off. We got some hot-footed frogs, though. I don't know if we can make something yet. That'll increase our resistance to cold. Or if we're going to want to come back later when we've got the warmer armor sets. Whoop. Well, that was a short-lived adventure. We didn't even save at all. Fine, we'll continue. I don't know if this one keeps track of how many times you die. I know Link's Awakening, there's a bonus where you get the true ending so long as you don't die. This one, I don't know that there is any such bonus at all. Oh. Well, that was some fancy work. Hey, we caught a lizard. There's that arrow we just casually threw away. Should have shot that bird. That's about what I'm looking for. Crouch. That's a rock. That's moblins. Wonder what kind of mischief they're up to here. See me yet. Oh, they saw me. We have a shield. And it's already going to be destroyed by these bees. And we're already about to die again. There we go. Back to health. This game has a lot of territory to explore. A heck of a lot. in it, there are a lot of things hidden. And also a whole bunch of other stuff that you can get from sources outside the game. We're talking amiibos, folks. And yeah, once we get to a point where we are able to use those, I have the full range of amiibos available, so we'll have Wolf Link, we'll have plenty of ingredients for cooking. There'll be special armor sets. And I'm not going to bore you all to tears by making you watch me run the same amiibo over and over and over again to get the special bonus set drops from each one every day. But we will do amiibo drops occasionally. But it's going to be the type of thing where when we do them, I'm just going to run through them quick. We'll drop all 25, I believe I have. Just right in a row. Whatever we get, we get. If we get something cool, awesome. If we don't get something cool, I ain't gonna worry about it. I will reserve the save exploit to keep cycling through to get better stuff for off stream. And I will try not to progress, you know, through the game without you guys. Like, I'll basically just do the amiibo lottery off stream. Occasionally we'll start our session with a quick, let's see what we get kind of thing. But the rest of the time, it's badly damaged. I wonder why. Makes a good torch, though. After all, I want to do 100% completion, and that's including set drops from amiibos, but I don't want to have to broadcast the very tedious task of having to keep cycling through when we don't get stuff that we want, because it's a lot of, oh, that one didn't drop anything good, reload our save game, try it again, reload our save game, try it again, reload the save game, try it again. Nobody wants to see that. This tree is already scored. I feel like we may have done that wrong. I don't know. If any of you are stumbling upon this and seeing that I've just screwed up another Korok seed puzzle, let me know. Ooh, we don't want those arrows. We want those arrows. Always worth it to spend a little time foraging. Who keeps a single apple in a barrel? Seriously. Whole barrel? You got one apple? Pitchfork. Can't carry any more melee. What do we got here? You know, let's get rid of one of these. As a matter of fact, let's get rid of two of these. There we go. Mushrooms. If I remember right, there is a guy later who's very interested in those. So it's definitely worth it to take our time and collect those if we can. I'm sorry, that was a whole bird there. You telling me I only get the drumstick? Come on now. Video game logic. I suppose, though, we're supposed to eat random slices of pizza off of the ground in some places. This? A spicy pepper. You know, I bet that'll keep us warm. It's another woodcutter's axe. Another torch. A pot lid. Well, that'll come in handy. Let's get rid of this tree branch. Seems to me we have plenty of tree branches. I'm feeling well equipped. Okay. So we've explored all of that. I mean, there's gonna be a lot more exploring around here, but I have every intention of taking kind of roundabout ways of getting on to our next objective, because there's a lot to explore in this game. Like, look at all these guys. You've got something underneath you. See, I didn't know about all of the little secrets and whatnot when I first played the game. So I probably missed a lot of stuff. Like, a lot of stuff. Thank you. Okay, that's gonna take more arrows than I've got. I do see a treasure chest there, though, that I want. I think this is one of those bonus chests from, yeah. This is one of the three expansion chests. If you get the expansion pass, get a bonus. Little out of place, but I like it. All right, so this is not where they want us to go yet. Oh, snap. He's awake. And he's pissed. Damn! That one singed my, singed my back hairs. Can I loot this guy? Whoop. Yeah, those guardians, they're relentless. Even when crippled, they are relentless.
Later in the game, we'll run into ones that are all,
crawling around and mobile still. By then, though, we should be equipped to handle them. Better equipped than we are now, that's for sure, because right now we're just, Alright, we can't get to that yet because we do not have the ability to... How are you able to target me from way over there? Jeez. I should be well out of range by now. Relentless, I swear. Just... they're awful. What? Dude just KO'd me. One shot. I do like how it tells you where you died. Puts a nice little X right there to let you know, hey, you ate it here. You ate it hard. If you're gonna try again, try not to die. That's right, sucker. I got you that time. Oh. Still got owned. Alright. Alright. I think they're trying to tell me something with the whole, hey, maybe don't just throw yourself at battle after battle and keep getting owned. Nah. That was a little more violent than I intended it to be, but, it got the job done. My bow's on fire. All of my bows are on fire. This better have been worth dying twice. Fire arrows. Eh, not bad. Worth dying twice? Eh, probably not. Hmm. I did. Yeah, it was effective. Oh boy. We're gonna avoid you guys for a little bit. It's the bird. It's the giant bird. I forgot that until you fight him, you can actually see him. Oh, you want to go punk? It would help if I equipped something. Hey. Can't carry anymore. I'm sure this has seen its last legs. No, not gonna let us climb on that, huh? Alright. I guess we have to climb down in here. Ah, cell phone charger. Perfect. Ain't gonna give it a virus, are ya? I just got this thing. And I'm pretty sure there isn't an Apple store for a billion miles from here. Please watch for falling rocks. What is that supposed to mean? Oh, son of a earthquake! How they put up them 5G towers so quickly. Now that's an informative map. the 5th of November?
You have been asleep.
That's tomorrow.
For the past 100 years.
Oh.
The beast. When the beast regains its true power, this world will face its end. Before it's too late.
Controversial opinion, but I was not a fan of the character Zelda in this particular Legend of Zelda. I know, kind of a weird, stance to take, but she comes across as incredibly, whiny at times. You are a princess who has seen war, for Christ's sake. Like, stop sounding every second like you're gonna break out into tears, lady.
Whoa, that's gonna hurt.
Oh, I can't believe we just fell off of that. No, I can believe that. That's completely on brand for me. Completely on brand. We are not graceful. Carefully now. Don't fall off again. Kind of wish I had one of those Nintendo shirts in real life. It's some serious swag, yo. Treasure chests on any of these ledges. Probably not. Calm down, old man. It's just 5G. All right? It's not going to give us all corona. Everybody's going to be fine. We'll have faster internet, though.
Thank you.
Let's not be rude. So you want me to go there, steal the treasure, and you'll give me the paraglider. Alright. That one there did get suspicious. Do I not have? I was gonna say I gotta have bows. See, now that was just rude of me. I knew where they were going. I took advantage of that. And I just wiped them right out. With a bomb. Well, bomb arrow. And that's kind of rude. Traveler's sword. My inventory's full. What? Alright, let's see, what do I want to get rid of? Get rid of that one. Keep that one. Because who knows what we're going to run into in this, this thing. Well, people who've played it before and remember, I'm sure they'll know. I don't remember though. It's been a year or two. When did I get this? 3-4 years ago? I don't even remember. Point is, it's been a while. Well, hello there. The second chest for having the expansion. Oh, we got a ruby. I mean, cool, but, like, it's not exactly great loot. Huh. Sure seems to be an awful lot of magnetic stuff around here. It's just an observation. But there's an awful lot of magnetic stuff around here. Those travel gates come in handy. I don't have magnesis yet.
Yeah.
That was an easy kill. I didn't even see it coming. Okay, so there is one there. I don't know if we're gonna need that one. I don't think we will. Think of it, we might need everything. Probably don't need everything, but, you know, why not bring it all, you know, why not bring everything? Worst that's gonna happen is we won't use it. I can live with that. I can grab that. I didn't think about that. Silly me. I can just pick it up off the shelf. Here I'm thinking I'm gonna have to build some crazy contraption to get up there. No, I just... Get rid of that. Get rid of that. I'd rather have a traveler's bow. And we have our first spirit orb. Only 119 more to go. Well, one of them is, you know, three times more. So that's basically what it's looked like for us so far. Just randomly haphazardly running around. Alright, so you want us to climb to the top of the tower. RIP. They ain't wrong about that. Cheater! Cheated. Mm-hmm. Okay. One, two, three. Nope. Dead. Oh. See, this is why you should have professionals service your G5 towers. Or your 5G towers. Don't get just random schmucks. Throw them in a corporate t-shirt. Before we forget again, because we did already once. We're up to 3. I'm probably running past, like, all kinds of them, because they are literally everywhere. Thank you. I didn't know if that'd be long enough. Ace arrows, nice. He got away. Darn frog. Last time we just, flung ourselves up there using the quick travel, but we also missed those chests. I want to make sure we're not missing stuff. Because a lot of the stuff I missed the last time I played this game. I missed it because I didn't bother taking a longer way around. Just sped through as much as I could. And the end result. Was I now have a game where I've beaten everything. Most everything. But I don't have hardly any Korok seeds. There's treasure chests everywhere. So with this playthrough, we're going to try to be a little more thorough. Told me that just before I fell off this thing and died. Yep. Because that's just how we roll. Want to put a pin there. Where is that other one? There it is. There. And... excuse me. I'm trying to get by you, sir. And there. Now, if you don't mind, going to carefully make my way down the tower this time. You know, when I said carefully, that's, there we go. We made it this time. We didn't die. Hooray. Okay, where's our first pin? Our first pin is that way. Oh, we ran past this one. We got shot at by a guardian. So we know they're awake over there. But we were able to get to the shrine without getting nuked, so I think we'll be alright. Hey, look, a butterfly. Yeah, that was another mistake I made when I played through this game the first time. I did not pick up nearly as much of the stuff as I should have as I passed it. Ended up with a lot less material for stuff later when I needed it. So this time, we're going to try not to pass up too much stuff, if we can. I see we are over on our time. But that's okay, because this is a good spot to save. When we pick this up next time, we'll complete the three other things up here on the Great Plateau. I'll also see if I can remember how much of the other stuff on the Great Plateau there is for us to find. Yep, wonderful. There's all kinds of stuff there. It's great. All right. Thanks for watching as I play Legend of Zelda Breath of the Wild. When I come back from lunch, I'm going to see about playing Red Dead again. We'll still do Breath of the Wild occasionally, but I intended to play Red Dead today, so I'm going to try to play Red Dead today. But this has been Murph plays some random game. Thanks for watching. Be sure to join the Discord if you're interested in chatting with me directly off the stream. If you have questions for me, comments, concerns, I got a whole platform there for you. Feel free to check out my website. If you follow me, I follow back. Y'all have a wonderful day. Thank you.